Hello, grade 12 students. Welcome to the accounting course. I'll be your tutor. My name is Peter Ramotala. I'm a second year VET student studying Bachelor of Accounting Sciences, and I matriculated in 2018. Obtained 99% in accounting and 7 distinctions, and 100% in both maths and physics. Yeah. So now, accounting is just a good course or a subject at your level, but it's just wonderful subject to study, and it has many possible career opportunities. For me, it's one of the most versatile subjects or qualifications you can have as a chartered accountant, because especially in the corporate world, because you become more dominant individual due to its versatility. You know, for there's a wide spectrum of choices for which you can choose the career or the path you want to take is after, you know, studying accounting at tertiary level. You can become a bookkeeper, a chartered accountant, director, CFO, CEO. You can be create your own accounting firm or own auditing firm. You can create your own business, become an entrepreneur. There's so many options. Hence, I'm saying it's one of the most versatile courses, and that also shows that it's an interesting course. So from grade 10 and 11, we know that the main purpose of accounting is to store the business or company's financial data, you know, and we store data for many reasons, but mostly for our stakeholders, because the stakeholders such as shareholders, they invested in the business and SARS for tax purposes, employees which want to know that their jobs are secure. So we store such data, and that such data is audited so that, you know, to enhance the reliability and validity of that data. So that's why we store such, you know, the financial data of a company. That's the main important thing about accounting. I know that's something you all know from grade 10 and 11. So there are many ways or techniques which you can use to tackle grade 12 accounting, but the most important thing is that you must love your maths. You must be a fan of maths. You must not hate maths. Maths is the basis for accounting. You must just love maths if you want to ace through your accounting exam. And you must also ensure that your grade 10 and 11 basics are solid. For example, you must know how to classify your accounts. If I say inventory, you must know whether it's an asset or a liability, and which side does it increase on, the debit or credit side. And you must just do as many question papers as you can. But the most important thing about this, doing your question papers, as many question papers as you can, is that you must make sure that you do the question paper only after you've mastered the content. You must not do the question paper while looking at your textbook or referring to your notes. You must do the question paper and be able to recall the content without looking at the textbook. So it acts as sort of like a mini exam for you. So you must do as many question papers as you can, and you must just practice accounting daily. There's an app which you can download at Google Play Store, which contains many questions, many practice questions which are extracted from different question papers. You can download that app from Google Store. Just search Grade 12 Accounting app. It will just appear and you'll download. I also have the link here where you can get any question paper for any year. You can just take the link, copy it, and search for those question papers. And lastly, guys, your accounting course comprises of two papers, paper one and paper two. Under paper one, you have your financial statements, your company financial statements, because we'll be dealing with companies this year. We'll have in your balance sheet, your income statement, and the new financial statement, which is called the cash flow statement. We also having analysis and interpretation of financial statement, which includes your financial indicators, your ratios, and your audit report. Will be having to comment on the reliability of the financial statement of a company. You also have your inventory valuation, inventory systems and valuations. Please note that your inventory systems and valuations, they appear twice. It appears twice, both in paper one and paper two. So you must make sure when you go write paper one and paper two, you prepare for it as two times. You also have your fixed asset, which is your note number three. You know, your fixed assets note, which include your land and buildings, equipment and vehicles. And the paper two, you have your budgeting, where you have your cash budget, your projected income statement, manufacturing, so cost accounting, we'll be having your production cost statement, which is a new thing, VAT calculations, your VAT control account, and inventory systems and valuation. As you know, I've spoken about it, you'll be introducing three new methods of valuing your inventory: FIFO method, weighted average, and the specific identification method. We're going to do all of those stuff, guys. And your reconciliations, lastly, which is your bank reconciliation, creditors reconciliation, and debtors reconciliations. I hope you enjoyed the course, guys, and I look forward to helping you ace the accounting course. Thank you very much.